It has been my great pleasure to have met with President Balaguer. His remarkable leadership has been an important element in the significant positive role that the Dominican Republic has played in regional affairs. President Balaguer has been a driving force throughout his country's democratic development. In 1966, he led democracy's return to the Dominican Republic after years of political uncertainty and turmoil. Indeed, he is, in many ways, the father of Dominican democracy. It's a great honor to have him here. The United States and the Dominican Republic traditionally have enjoyed very close and warm relations. Our meeting today reflected the important historical, cultural, political, and economic ties that bind our two countries. We discussed the economic problems that face us and examined possible solutions. President Balaguer described the serious impact that low world sugar prices and declining market access are having on the Dominican Republic. I applaud his government's courageous efforts to meet difficult economic and developmental challenges through diversification and private sector investment. The United States government wants to participate in these processes. Within our budget limitations, we will continue to support development and growth in the Dominican Republic. Sharing a common hemisphere and democratic beliefs, we examined important political developments elsewhere in the Caribbean and Latin America. We are both concerned by recent events in Central America and Panama. I deeply appreciate President Balaguer's insights into these issues. We both hope for democratic and peaceful solutions to the problems of the region. We want to see an end to the pursuit of military solutions and to the massive Soviet armament that fuels that pursuit. I congratulated the President on his government's role in hosting the first Nicaraguan peace talks mediated by Cardinal Obando y Bravo. We discussed bilateral cooperation in the critical area of narcotics. And I want personally to thank President Balaguer for his assistance in combating illegal narcotics in the Caribbean. His government's efforts have been crucial, and we look forward to continued cooperation on this matter of national and hemispheric security. So thank you again, Mr. President, for coming to visit me today in Washington. You're a close and good friend of the United States, a leader dedicated to freedom, democracy, and peace, a trusted ally. I wish you well and look forward to working with you as our two countries face the challenges of the future. Thank you, and God bless you.
Para mí ha sido un motivo de profunda satisfacción visitar en el día de hoy, el día de primavera en Washington, al presidente Reagan. El honor que se me ha dispensado no lo recibo yo personalmente, sino mi pequeño país, la República Dominicana. He venido principalmente a testimoniar al presidente Reagan la admiración mía y la admiración de todos los dominicanos por la valerosa política que ha llevado a cabo como líder mundial en favor de la promoción de los derechos humanos, en favor del progreso de los regímenes democráticos, tanto en la América Latina como en el resto del mundo. Hemos pasado revista a los problemas que conciernen a las relaciones bilaterales entre los dos países y hemos pasado también revista a problemas que afectan a las diferentes naciones de la América Latina, todos inspirados en la política del presidente Reagan de promover la democracia, de promover la libertad y de ayudar a los países débiles en su recuperación económica. La República Dominicana ha recibido grandes ayudas de los Estados Unidos bajo el gobierno del presidente Reagan, sobre todo mediante la aplicación del Plan Reagan para la Cuenca del Caribe. Creo que es la iniciativa más constructiva que ha partido de los Estados Unidos en sus relaciones con los países latinoamericanos. Ha sido una política más práctica y provechosa para nosotros que la vieja política de buena vecindad del presidente Roosevelt, que la política de la Alianza del Progreso del presidente Kennedy, porque la Alianza para el Progreso como la política de vecindad fueron fórmulas de política teórica. En cambio, la ayuda para la región del Caribe, el Plan Reagan para el Caribe, se ha traducido pragmáticamente en realizaciones de gran provecho para la economía de nuestros países. La República Dominicana, mediante el Plan Reagan, ha podido mejorar sustancialmente su economía, resolver parte de sus problemas sociales mediante la construcción de zonas francas, de zonas abiertas donde se han establecido industrias extranjeras que han contribuido a disminuir el desempleo en la República Dominicana. Además, con el Plan Reagan hemos podido exportar a los Estados Unidos al amparo de tarifas arancelarias muy reducidas o totalmente eliminadas, grandes cantidades de ropa confeccionada en la República Dominicana. Hemos podido también exportar muchos productos de la más diversa clase hacia los Estados Unidos al amparo de esas reformas arancelarias. La consecuencia de ese esfuerzo es que el desempleo ha disminuido sustancialmente en la República Dominicana. Aún quedan pendientes algunos problemas en nuestras relaciones, especialmente el problema de la reducción de la cuota azucarera. Hemos conversado con el presidente Reagan acerca de ese problema y también lo hemos hecho con sus colaboradores más distinguidos, que se relacionan más con la solución de ese problema. Hemos también tratado el problema en el Congreso en la mañana de hoy con un grupo de senadores, senadores amigos de la República Dominicana. Hemos hallado un ambiente propicio y creo que el problema será considerado en su oportunidad y se resolverá de acuerdo con el interés de ambos países. Las relaciones entre los dos países desde el punto de vista internacional en relación con los problemas que afectan a otros países del área han sido también muy constructivas. Hemos coincidido en todo lo fundamental en cuanto a la política que debe seguirse con el gobierno de Haití y con otros países vecinos. Hay una coincidencia total en los puntos de vista entre la política de los Estados Unidos y los de la República Dominicana. Me complace expresar las gracias al presidente Reagan por la hospitalidad que me ha ofrecido, por la cordialidad con que me ha tratado, por las distinciones que mi persona ha hecho a la República Dominicana. Si llego a mi país, me preguntarán si traigo las manos llenas o las manos vacías. Yo diría que sí, que las llevo a mi país llenas de amistad, de cariño, de admiración hacia los Estados Unidos y a su gran líder, el presidente Reagan. Estas expresiones de admiración hacia el presidente Reagan no son nuevas en mi persona. Siempre en público y en privado las he pronunciado de una manera abierta, reconociendo que era un líder no solo continental, sino también universal, por su política económica revolucionaria, por su probada lealtad a los regímenes democráticos de la América Latina y del mundo por su lucha contra el narcotráfico. Y a este propósito, me complace expresar muy respetuosamente mis sentimientos de rendida admiración a Nancy, la esposa del presidente Reagan, la primera dama de los Estados Unidos. Su lucha humanitaria contra las drogas es un ejemplo para las mujeres de todo el mundo. Es un ejemplo especialmente para los países de la América Latina que están sufriendo los efectos de esa plaga y que están conscientes de que hay que hacer un esfuerzo, el mayor que esté en nuestras manos, para erradicarla totalmente y salvar por ese conducto a nuestra sociedad, sobre todo a nuestra juventud, de esa plaga que está corrompiendo a la sociedad universalmente. Muchas gracias, presidente Reagan. Crea que su política económica de saneamiento de la economía norteamericana, lo que equivale a decir también que de saneamiento de la política y de la economía del mundo entero, nos irá sirviendo de inspiración y de guía. Siempre estaremos conscientes de que debemos fortalecer los derechos humanos, de que debemos seguir disminuyendo el desempleo y resolviendo los problemas de carácter social que afectan a cada uno de nuestros países. Es la política que Vuestra Excelencia ha seguido y la que debemos seguir todos y seguiremos todos en la República Dominicana. Muchas gracias, señor presidente.
Mr. President, this is a beautiful spring day to pay this visit on President Ronald Reagan, which is a great honor to me, but not really to me, but an honor which is really a distinction on my country. I have told President Reagan today of not only my personal admiration, but that of the whole people of the Dominican Republic, for himself personally, for his policies as a leader of the world in the defense of human rights and for the progress of democratic regimes in Latin America and throughout the world. Together, we have reviewed the bilateral problems and issues between our two countries. We have also reviewed the problems affecting other Latin American countries. All these countries have been inspired by President Reagan's policies in the areas of democracy, liberty, and for helping the weak toward economic recovery. The Dominican Republic has received a great deal of help from the Reagan administration, especially in terms of the Caribbean Basin Initiative. This is the most constructive initiative which has ever come to Latin America. It is the most practical initiative and the one from which we have derived the most advantage. And here I include the good neighbor policy of Roosevelt and the Alliance for Progress of President Kennedy, because those were theoretical abstractions, whereas the Caribbean Basin Initiative has been a pragmatic movement which has achieved a great deal of practical good for our countries. The Dominican Republic specifically has improved its economy, has progressed, has established a large number of free trade zones, opening foreign industries, and thus has reduced its unemployment rate a great deal. Also, the Reagan plan has permitted us to export more to the United States because of the lowering or total elimination of tariffs. We have exported more clothes, more apparel manufactured in the Dominican Republic, as well as other products which we have now started exporting to the United States thanks to the lowering of tariff barriers, with once again the consequence of lowering unemployment. There are problems which subsist in our relations, especially in connection with the lowering of our sugar quota, but this we have discussed with President Reagan and with his senior advisors in this area of expertise. We also discussed the subject this morning on Capitol Hill with a number of senators who are friends of the Dominican Republic. We found there a very receptive climate and feel confident that the problem will be solved, taking into account the interests of both of our countries. Our talks today regarding our policies vis-a-vis other countries of the region have been ones in which we have agreed on almost every point. We agreed, for example, on the subject of Haiti, and on in our discussions of other countries which are our neighbors. And we have almost total and virtual agreement between the two countries. It is a great pleasure to me now to thank you, President Reagan, very warmly for your hospitality, for your great cordiality, and the honor which this visit has done to my country, the Dominican Republic. If when I get home I am asked if I come with my hands full or my hands empty, I will say that my hands are very full, full of friendship, full of affection, and full of admiration for the United States and for its president, Ronald Reagan. My admiration for Ronald Reagan is nothing new. It is something which I have always spoken of, saying that he is not only a leader of his country and of the continent, but a world leader with his revolutionary economic policies, his loyalty to democratic regimes everywhere, and his fight against drug trafficking in the world. And here I would like just to interject a word of admiration for Mrs. Reagan, for Nancy, the First Lady, whose human struggle against drug trafficking stands as an example to women all over the world, especially in Latin America, which is suffering so much from this scourge, telling us all that we all must make our own efforts to eradicate this plague in order to save the youth of this generation and succeeding generations. Thank you, President Reagan. Believe me, your economic policies leading to the recovery of the American economy are also leading to the recovery of economies throughout the world. You will continue always to be an inspiration and a guide to me. I am always conscious of your struggle to increase the defense of human rights, to reduce unemployment, to solve the social problems of the world.
Considering everything, but I can't take it more.
What do you want Secretary Schultz to say to the Palestinians, Mr. President?
Can you see anything? about Villanova winning last night.
Yeah.